Thank you very much, and it's really a pleasure for me to be here. I won't keep you very long, but I wanted to say at the beginning that this is a sort of homecoming for me. I got my undergraduate degree, or my first graduate degree in economics in this very place a few years ago, and I must say I didn't know then how strong this university is in accounting. Maybe I should have taken a few further courses, but I then went on to just study economics. And when I first heard about the importance of public sector accounting and balance sheets, I must admit I was somewhat skeptical. But slowly I'm beginning to see their usefulness. And that is also why I wanted to just take a few minutes to show you an initiative which we are taking at CEPS in conjunction with some people here present to advance the idea of accountability and transparency at the European level. And what we are trying to do, or what we will do at CEPS, is to constitute a, what we call a task force, a group of people to think about these issues. And to make a complicated story short, the purpose is quite simple. At present, as you have heard, we have only a few member countries which prepare balance sheets and otherwise are really transparent in fiscal terms. At the same time, the European Union has a very strong interest in seeing more transparency at all levels. And this is, I think, an opportunity to get the EU level to push member states to do something which they might not do if you were to go to them individually. And the basic point is that, and I think some of you have experienced that, when you go to member states individually, very often you get a reaction that says, yes, balance sheet and more transparency is very nice in general, but don't bother me. It is more difficult for us. Transparency is not always in my own personal interest. Of course, finance ministers and finance ministry officials are not familiar very often with balance sheet concepts, and then they would loathe the additional work. So the general reaction is, nice idea in theory, but why us? We are doing fine, right? Now, the nice point for me is that the EU institutions have somewhat different incentives. They actually need this transparency. If you just look at the recent experience with the Stability Pact and the great doubt now within even the EU institutions, whether these statistical concepts like cyclically adjusted and structural deficits and so on are useful, when a properly prepared balance sheet with fair value accounting can give you a much better idea of the really risks behind the present situation and what the full fiscal implications are of certain decisions which are being taken, then you can see that at the EU level, there should be a great interest in actually having this tool at their disposal. So basically, you can complement and to some extent substitute the statistical measures from the SGB, from the Stability and Growth Pact, with better accounting figures. And then finally, somewhat cynically perhaps, the additional work and effort would be for the others, not for them. So my position would be that it might be easier to advance this idea and push the policy needle at the EU level rather than going member states one by one. And that's what we're trying to do with this task force. And the working method is quite simple. We are trying to get together the three constituencies which at the medium level within the EU framework have a lot of influence. And that is the independent experts from academia, in this case maybe also the accountancy professions, industry representatives, and then the policy making officials from the institutions and the member states. right? We have to get a lot of people on board and a lot of people together to agree on common concepts. But when you can do that, when you get these people to agree and have recommendations from such a group, our experience at CEPS is that then sometimes you can move the policy needle and get some significant progress. So what we propose to do is to get together such a group of people, 20, 30, thereabouts. We meet three or four times over the course, let's say, of 1 year. And then the key output is usually, as I said, this final report with policy recommendations and the concrete way how to go forward at the EU level, what framework could be set at the EU level, under what legal conditions, and so on. And that could then filter upstairs to those who are political responsible. And as I said, that's what we are proposing to do. We have, I think, found a very authoritative chairman, Enrico Giovannini, the former minister in Italy, and he was the head of the Italian Statistical Office. So somebody who knows both the politics and the practical and statistical issues involved. And with this, I think I have said enough. Anybody who is interested in joining should contact CEPS, me or my colleague there. And we are looking for an intensive period of later this year to try to push for meaningful change at the EU level. I think the timing is now, given the difficulties with the SGP, and given the opening that we have in a number of member countries, not least the successful experience in Austria. You always need to be able to point to a credible member country where this has been implemented and has been done. And therefore, I just want to tell you, this might be a good occasion to advance something which we all believe in. Thank you very much.